is like no other airport on Earth.
Welcome to Thailand!
This is my best smiling.
It's where East meets West.
Ching, 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 ching.
Buddhist meets backpacker.
That way to the beach.
And traveller meets trouble.
You ever see me in Thailand ever again?
No!
Yes!
And if the culture seems strange, the language seems foreign, and you're 6,000 miles from home,
I'm stuck in Bangkok.
Don't panic. There's an army of airport staff just waiting to help you out. One way,
how may I help you?
Or another,
get in the line.
So whether it's your gateway to a million once-in-a-lifetime experiences,
it's all about love, love, love and love,
or just the ticket to a good old-fashioned holiday nightmare,
look at all the cancelled flights.
This is your final call.
Very happy, everyone.
Welcome, that's what please, to Bangkok Airport.
I'm addicted to you.
Tonight at Bangkok Airport, all you need is love.
Oh my God, I can give you a kiss right now, man.
Romance blossoms for immigration officers Bert and Nat.
He is my boyfriend.
But don't tell anybody, okay?
Nathan has a surprise in store for his mum and dad.
My boyfriend is here, so I'll be introducing them to him.
I'm addicted to you!
And will a nip and tuck help Justin land the girl of his dreams?
I'm not ashamed or embarrassed. Yeah, I am single and, you know, I hope that one day I will find somebody special.
It's one of the biggest days in the Thai calendar and love is in the air.
It's all about getting down, baby, getting down, baby.
It's not just the passengers who are feeling frisky this Valentine's Day. The staff, too, are all loved up.
I love my work. I love my job. I love trains.
It's all about love.
Up at check-in, Barry has a not-so-secret admirer.
He is very handsome. Yeah.
His boyish good looks haven't escaped the eye of his colleague, Bean.
So... I like him. He is chubby and he is white. He is
chubby.
I wanna hug him. I wanna pinch him.
Hi, you again.
Over in immigration, Captain Jack has just married the girl of his dreams.
My wife and I, we are happy together. Yeah. She loves me more than words that I can say.
Jack proposed in dramatic fashion.
I go to my girlfriend's workplace and I pretend that I'm faint in front of her, and she come to help me, and after that I propose her, ask her to marry me. Yeah.
Jack knows a successful relationship, like entering a new country, is just a matter of obeying the rules.
I kiss her before leaving house, kiss her before sleep, and if I stick to the rule, I will have no problem with her.
But if it's romance you're after, look no further than visa on arrivals.
Welcome to Thailand.
Working side by side has brought Captain Burz and Officer Nat close. But how close?
Oh, that is a difficult question.
He is my boyfriend.
But don't tell anybody, okay?
We didn't tell anyone. Yeah, a bit secret. But now it's not a secret. Bird? But just cut it off.
So now their secret's out. Kind of. How will they celebrate Valentine's Day?
I cannot guess what he's gonna do, and I think he's not romantic.
You know, Valentine's Day, blah blah blah.
But it's okay. I think, yeah, it's not important for me.
But that's wrong. Bert's got something up his sleeve.
She is a girl, and I think maybe I must do some romantic thing to her on this day.
I think I'm gonna come back home, and my boyfriend, he just say, happy Valentine. Yeah, that's it.
Bert's going to introduce Nat to someone else who's very special in his life.
My grandmom is coming to the airport tonight. She's coming from San Francisco. I think I will bring her to North Dakota. We keep it in our secret, but I think she will be surprised.
No, I know nothing. She didn't tell me about anything.
That's in for a big surprise when Granny tips up and they say romance is dead. Not everyone's feeling the love this Valentine's Day. Tal from Cardiff missed his flight when it left on time and left him in the queue.
I came here early, I came here like 6 o'clock, checked in. It was the immigration side. As soon as I got into immigration and the luggage side and check-in, that took like almost 45 minutes the most. You know, they should have waited for me to be fair, but they didn't. You know, the plane was still there, the staff was still there, they just couldn't put me on.
There's another flight checking in at 6, but Tal's run out of cash. He'll have to blag his way onto it.
It's going to time to get me my flight back. I ain't going to move until they say, like, I'm just going to stick to my story and just say, look, came here on time, you guys left, the plane was still here, so it's not really my fault. Okay, the sob story.
I wonder if you help me. I'm in desperate need of help here.
Sorry. Just say to me that this ticket not showing up as far, so you're going to buy a new ticket.
Oh, God. Surely there's something you can do, yeah, because this is not my fault. Is this for real, or...? Wow. Guys don't want to help me, man.
The airline offers him the chance to transfer his ticket, but it's still going to cost.
How much is it going to be?
$8,135.
This is what I
tried. Final. You don't.
Yeah, I know. I understand. I appreciate you helping me anyway. So, okay, I'm gonna have to struggle to get this money. Oh man, it's not good, man. It's not good. $8,000 you want? It's a joke.
Flipping heck! What am I gonna bloody do? Shit.
It's only around 150 quid, but right now, Tal's not got it.
So now I'm gonna have to start making some phone calls or something. It's just hectic.
And if he can't get it in the next 4 hours, he'll be going nowhere.
It's a joke. Shit is a joke.
Perhaps what Tal needs is a big hug.
Hello, free hug.
And today, tourist ambassador Sun Rui is giving them out for free.
Free hug. Oh, happy Valentine. Free hugs.
Hello. Today is the Valentine Day. I will try to tell him many things about Thailand, yes, and give them the gift, a precious gift from Thailand.
Valentine's Day, we would like to say that it's the big day of love. I would like to send love to everyone and to you also and to others.
Who could resist a free hug from Sun Rui on Valentine's Day?
He said, I love you.
There seems to be more shrugs than hugs from passing passengers until...
Wow! This is love in Thai. Wow, Brad! Wow!
Yeah, we're on honeymoon!
You are on honeymoon!
Yeah.
Hello, man! Happy Valentine's!
It takes a pair of newlyweds to finally share the love with Sun Rui.
This one for you! Okay, 10 photos together!
3,000 passengers pass through Bangkok Airport every day, and not all of them can get a hug. That would be impossible.
My name is Justin Hoffman. I'm here for the whole cosmetic surgery experience.
Justin's hoping a nip and tuck will bring him luck with the ladies. Pook helps arrange his trip.
Yeah, they come to Thailand a lot. You can come for holiday, and also here is cheaper, and also the doctor is good here.
When I go out on a date, well, I'm just not happy with the way that I look. I've got an opportunity here to do something about it, and I say, why not go for it?
It's not strange for man to do facelift, because everybody can do facelift. Just only make you good looking, man or woman. Only if he do implant is this strain.
Having done some research, this was the place to come to. And I could have done it in Australia, but I wouldn't have gotten as much bang for my buck.
There we go. Hello.
Hey, Justin.
Hello, Justin. My name is Pope. So happy to see you.
Oh, thank you very much.
Excellent. Now we walk to the...
Fantastic. All right. Great. Fantastic. Let's go. Okay. Ready to go? I'm so glad you guys are here because I'm way out of my depth right now.
So. You nervous? Don't tell me that.
Oh, well. Well, no, I'm not nervous. It's all so new.
No, I mean, you're not nervous about surgery. I think you're nervous about Thailand because I have so many things in here, especially women.
A staggering 2.5 million people come to Thailand every year for surgery. Justin's holiday with a facelift has cost him around £5,000. And for that, Pook throws in a little light flirting.
Are you married?
No.
Really? Oh my God, you are a single guy and come first time. The tiger is really interesting on you then.
We'll see.
I don't know,
I'm going to be all bruised up.
I can guarantee 100%. If you walk on the street, they will see, oh, handsome guy, come here. They'll be interesting you a lot.
Maybe when I'm healed up and I'm after the surgery, maybe we'll see how it goes.
But I will warn you with one thing.
Yeah.
I have so many girls, a lot.
Yeah.
You have to take a look for, not hardly take one. If you take one, that means you cannot chain anyone.
Right.
In the first one.
Yeah.
Because they will not let you go.
I guess you're never too old to learn new lessons in love.
You're too old? How old are you?
No, well, I'm 38.
38?
Yeah, I'm nearly.
You're more old than me, only 1 year.
Really?
Yeah.
But you look so young.
Justin's obviously a bit of a smoothie, and after tomorrow, he'll be even smoother.
Even though I'm here right now, it's still unreal to me. Yeah, I guess as it is getting very close, there's that tickle of nervousness to me, but I've just got to take the bull by the horns, so to speak, and just go for it.
Back at the airport, there's still no love for Tal.
Aye, aye, aye.
He needs money to transfer his ticket, and he's getting desperate.
I need to jack someone. That's what I need to do. Jack someone right now. Take their money off them and then cash my flight home. Borrow a motorbike and just go and rob someone now. It's the only option I got. No one else is going to help me. Just don't know what to do.
Yeah, I need to try and get the next flight back.
You want to share the ticket? Right.
Tal decides to share his troubles with the tourist police.
I need help. I don't know what to do.
Newly engaged couple Pete and Bex can't help earwigging.
Basically, I'm just doomed right now. I don't know what to do. Like, I came here at like 6 o'clock, and because of the immigration, it just took too long just to get through. By the time I got past the immigration, the flight was still there, and they wouldn't let me in.
Okay.
I was 10 minutes late.
What are they saying about the next flight?
They're saying the next flight is 8 o'clock tonight, but it's going to have to cost me like 8,000 baht, so I have no money on me, so I'm trying to like contact someone. Hopefully they can sort it out.
Pete and Bex are sympathetic, up to a point.
I feel for him because his plans have been messed up, but that's why you should always have...
Is he going now?
Yeah, but always have emergency money.
Yeah.
You should always have credit cards, some way of accessing money if things like that happen.
Tal's only hope is to find a friend back home who'll send him the money. Tourist police officer Bai Tong helps him get online.
I have to take care some of the tourists who have the problem, like that guy. I have to help him.
But it's 6 in the morning in Wales, not the best time to ask for a loan.
I'm trying to contact my brother. He's just not picking up.
It's a signal. Signal's weak.
This is the message I'm getting from my mates. You're full of shit.
Just can't believe they don't want to help me, like.
How come they don't want to help me?
I said, I need 150 quid. My mate's like, I need a 10 pack.
Just don't know what to do.
Well, I'm in a situation here, though.
What's this, a witness thing going on? Is it? What's going on here?
No, no one wants to know. No one wants to help. This is the problem.
At last, one of his friends offers to help.
There you go, one of my mates might be coming through. Mate, can I use your battery? My battery's running out.
If you can do that, I appreciate that, seriously. Because I am in a situation here and I really don't know what to do.
Got 1 hour now to get on a flight. This all depends how quick you can send this money now. Got to go and check the bank now, man. Hope for the best. Ding, ding, second round.
So Tal heads for the cash machines, but if the money's not gone in, he won't be getting out. Over in immigration, Bert is planning a Valentine's Day surprise for his girlfriend Nat.
Take someone to meet her tonight, but I didn't say who.
In Thai culture, family is everything, and Bert's keen that Nat gets approval from his favourite relative.
Yeah, I'm going to pick my grandmom up. I think I will surprise Nat because I will take my grandmom to Nat counter, and Nat will do immigration to her passport, and I introduce my grandmom to Nat.
Bert's not seen his granny for ages.
I miss her so much. Long time to see her. My grandmom is 85 years old. I think she haven't seen me in this uniform before. It is the first time of her to see me in immigration suit, just like this.
And there's another surprise coming up. As they approach immigration, Bird casually drops Nat into the conversation.
I know Nat.
So the big moment arrives. As Nat inspects Bert's granny's passport, Bert's granny inspects Nat. So, does Nat get the stamp of approval?
The only one word that she said. Beautiful.
For the true romantic, airports can be exciting places, full of tearful goodbyes and joyful reunions. At her desk in arrivals is information officer Jibidu.
How may I help you?
She has a front row seat.
What I love most, if we sit in the arrival hall, you will see people crying when they met each other. And they hug each other, and they kiss, and they cry. And I love it. My heart is full of happiness. Yes, and maybe because I live alone, that's why I need this feeling so much, somewhere that we belong and we feel good, we feel loved, we feel warm. Yeah, I need to be there.
Airports can be lonely places too, full of disappointment, even betrayal. Over at Tourist Police HQ, a Swiss passenger is looking for assistance after he was stood up. Lending a sympathetic ear is Officer Ake.
You have flight today?
Flight.
You have flight today?
Flight.
After a six-month internet romance, Herr Puppikoffer flew in from Switzerland to meet his Thai sweetheart.
She's got to be here, right? She's got to be here.
But today, she's nowhere to be seen, and now he's lost his phone, he can't even call her.
He told me that she's supposed to be here to pick him to go to the hotel, but she's not show up. She disappears.
Ake tries getting hold of the woman on the number he's been given, but it's all too much for Herr Puppikoffer.
He cries. I don't know what's wrong with him. It's my his first love, I think.
An email comes through from the lady explaining why she's not shown up.
My God, ladies, sorry.
She sends another number, so the officers give that a try.
พี่คะเนี่ยพอดีว่ามิสเตอร์ที่เป็นคนเยอรมันนะคะส่วนพี่ต่อเมลพี่ไปเมื่อกี้ค่ะเขาอยู่ที่ตำรวจท่องเที่ยวสนามบินสุวรรณภูมิมาค่ะตอนนี้ก็ร้องไห้แล้วก็ร้องไห้อยู่ค่ะพี่เซอร์ให้ทำใจกันบ้างพี่
โอเค
She
called back now
Unfortunately for Herr Puppikoffer, his girlfriend doesn't seem that keen to see him. Seems she's had second thoughts about their relationship. And it turns out the lady is married with children. After a brief conversation, the woman promises to meet him in a Bangkok hotel tomorrow. But has she told him everything? Should the police step in? But in an affair of the heart, even the tourist police are powerless to act.
We try to help him, but it's like a sensitive story. We try to help him, but I do that. We do that we can do.
That's all we can do.
Still, it makes a change from the usual lost property. In a way,
it feels like he lost something. It's like valuable property. It's like credit card or money. No, he just lost girl, lost someone. It's all about love.
Over at Arrivals, Nathan from Merseyside's come for a family reunion.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how nervous am I? About 10.
Nathan's hardly seen his parents, Pat and Ken, since he moved to Bangkok 4 years ago.
Amazing airport,
yeah,
isn't
huge,
it?
Huge, isn't it? Yeah.
So when he didn't come back for Christmas, they kind of invited themselves.
It came on a chance remark on FaceTime on New Year's Day, and I said, are you coming home at Easter? He said, oh, I don't know. And I said, well, we could come there. And so that's why we're coming.
They don't really know my life here. So
they don't really know that much about me, except for what I tell them on the phone, which isn't a lot, really.
Now they're here, Pat's determined to make the most of it.
Look here, water rafting, and they go water rafting and climbing.
Pat's the sort of person that says, let's go elephant riding and white water rafting and other things like that. It goes on and on, they say.
It's quite concrete, isn't it, though? Yeah. They are quite concrete. Yeah.
Sounds like Ken's more of the stay-at-home type.
I'm not really into travelling. I am a home bird. You know, when you live on the world, you don't need to go anywhere else, really, you know.
It's been a while, but Nathan seems to know what to expect.
They can't stop talking. So they'll have met people on the plane. They'll be having a conversation.
Lots of people say to you, oh, you're so fortunate. Going, where are you going? Thailand. Or we'll go to Thailand.
I imagine they won't be here on time. They'll be quite slow.
So it was... Has it got you the E number there? What were we on?
They probably won't know what their banks look like either.
Of course.
I mean, that won't sneak past me. You're just trying to make me look silly.
There's another very good reason for Nathan's first night nerves. Pat and Ken have never met his new fella, Ark.
My boyfriend is here, so I'll be introducing them to him. We've been together for about a year. And he's a lovely guy. He's Thai, and he speaks good Thai, which is good for them, because he'll be able to order properly in a restaurant, which I can't do that well. My Thai is okay, but it's not great. I've never seen it before. So it'll be interesting to see their reaction.
Can you see him? I can see him straight ahead over there.
Hello.
It's lovely to see you.
See you, mate.
Hello. Great to see you.
Thank you, mums. Okay, pride. Well done.
So it's back to Nathan's to freshen up for dinner and the big meeting with Ark.
Are you ready?
Justin's arrived at a Bangkok hospital for his facelift.
Looking forward to getting in there and see what happens next, really.
He's facing the surgeon's knife today, and he knows nothing's going to be the same again.
Yeah, it's a strange thought. The image that you look at in a mirror is not the one I'm going to wake up with, you know, so that has definitely crossed my mind this morning for sure, so, exciting.
Pook's come along to help take Justin's mind off things, and she's soon back on her favourite subject, love and romance.
Last night, my husband, he said, oh, he will fall in love for sure. Before all Thai women take care good and then lovely, then you start have feeling warm and have some feeling with the who take care of you.
Yeah.
But they're already lovely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's in Thailand, it's a very romantic country, isn't it?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
And Thai women are soft. I take care of you all.
Oh, and I need taken care of.
Mercifully, the nurse arrives to whisk Justin in for his consultation.
Follow her? Yeah.
All right. The op will be carried out by one of Thailand's leading cosmetic surgeons, Dr. Titi.
Hi, I'm Dr. Titi.
So I'm here to tackle the problem of these deep laugh lines that are around my eyes and my cheeks. You know, what I would like is so that when I do smile, it's very smooth and taut, and just to really have that appearance reduced, you know.
So I want to start. We start from your hairline around here,
yeah.
And then go get along in front of your ears, and back down behind your ears around here. Main thing is when you pull it upward and backward,
yeah.
So your sideburn will be high up a little bit,
yeah.
From here up to here.
Okay.
So you might have to change your hairstyle a little bit.
Pre-operation nerves are definitely beginning to hit a little bit. I don't know if it's because I've barely eaten anything and I haven't had a coffee yet, but the risks, while small, are there.
Consultation over, it's time to get ready.
Well, this makes it very real now, so... Nice comfortable gown.
Sorry.
Oh, the slippers, yes. Lovely. Very comfortable.
He's comfortable for now, but it won't be long before Justin's wheeled into theatre to face the scalpel. back at the airport, love still in the air. And in his immigration booth, newlywed Captain Jack still happy. He knows he's made the perfect match.
I am the one who cooks. She doesn't cook. And I don't do laundry thing. So she does laundry. I don't do it. I cannot iron. I found the perfect one for me. We are super in common. And when you found someone in really in common, you will let them go? No. You will get married.
Across the airport, Sun Rui is still giving out free hugs. And now her colleague Nok Young has joined in with heart-shaped stickers.
This sticker I give everyone today, only today. Happy Valentine's Day, happy Valentine's Day. For the couples, it's so special. Many, many couples come to Thailand.
And Nok Young's had a surprise present of her own from an airport admirer.
This morning, this flower and Ferrero Rocher. I cannot eat because fat. I keep in my room.
So, is this the start of a new romance?
Surprise.
Nok Young's playing it cool.
Not sure. Maybe in the future.
But not everyone's got that loving feeling. After missing his flight, Tao spent nearly 12 hours trying to get a new ticket.
Sorry, love.
A friend sent him the cash.
Sorry.
But will it hit his bank in time?
It's not in my card, no. My mate just sent me money then, so hopefully if it goes through, no. Happy days, I'm home. No, my luck's probably not in there. Oh, man, fingers crossed, no. English. Ballads. Current. Oh, it's not gone through. Yeah, I'm not going to make it. It's just not going to happen, is it? It's 5:30 now. 6:00, she said.
But when you've got nothing, you've got nothing to lose. Town gives it one last go at the airline desk.
My friend put the money in, so hopefully it's gone through. Oh my God, so stressed.
Then a Valentine's Day miracle.
It's gone, yeah? Oh my God, my heart is beating. Oh my God.
Somewhere between cash point and desk, his mate's money's gone in.
Okay, this is going to Abu Dhabi and then going to London?
Yeah.
Oh my God, I can give you a kiss right now, man.
No, thank you.
Check in now, yeah? Bunka, thank you. I can smell freedom right here. After all that stress I went through then. Made it, man. Get out. Just can't believe it, like. Big up to my mate Kane McKenzie, for sending me some money. You know I'm not paying you back, bro, you know that, innit?
But having been here a whole day, he's now late for his flight again.
Bloody hell. It's like deja vu coming here, you know? Where's D6? D6? D6. Oh, such a stress on that, like, madness.
Tao just makes it to the gate on time. It's taken the whole of Valentine's Day, but he's learnt an important lesson.
One tip, check in on time.
While Tao jets off, Nathan's brought his parents to a Bangkok riverside restaurant.
So that's a dinner cruise, I think.
He's going to introduce Pat and Ken to his new boyfriend, Ark.
Here's Ark.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey.
Good to meet you, Ark.
Hi. Yes.
Good to see you. Mum, Dad.
Ark. Hi. Nice to meet you.
Lovely to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Check a suit. Oh. Don't you think he looks like Will.i.am a little bit?
Yeah, he's nice looking at Will.i.am. Much nicer.
When he smiles, he's a little bit... Look, that smile.
First impressions seem pretty good, and Pat seems to be taking a bit of a shine to Ark.
You've got lovely dark hair, haven't you?
Can you do Liverpool accent? Say shit.
No. I like it though. I really like Liverpool accent. I think it's very... I like, you know, like... It's like American, they have their southern accent, right?
Yes.
Something about it is very homely.
Yes.
And people have an accent.
Well, Liverpool people are very friendly. We're very friendly.
So, have things gone as well as everyone hoped?
It's always difficult to introduce your boyfriend to your parents, but the parents are getting on really well with Ark, and Ark doesn't seem uncomfortable to meet the family. So, yeah, they're connecting really well, having a good conversation, having a good laugh. Yeah, so surprisingly well.
I was a little bit nervous in the beginning, meeting the parents. I meet them as a, you know, as a partner, you know what I mean? So I was a little bit, you know, they're going to accept it, but I saw what Nathan inherited in himself. Like, he got a sense of humor from his dad, you know, and something that he told me, he got it from his mom, you know, things like that. And he's nice, lovely, yeah.
Art was really friendly and very open about his family and what he'd done in his life. We had a nice chat, it was good, yeah.
Yeah, it's a good vibe, isn't it? Really easy going, yeah. But most of Nathan's boyfriends have been easy going, haven't they? Yeah. You know, Nathan's first boyfriend was a rugby player, wasn't he? He had blonde hair, so there's a variety. Yeah, he hasn't got a standard stereotype. You know.
It's a new day at Bangkok Airport, but love's still in the air.
Oh my goodness!
Joy's come to meet her boyfriend, Salim, off the plane from Lagos, after 3 months apart.
I missed him so much. Like, I'm so excited to see him. Like, it's been so long.
Her sister, Jewel, has been trying to keep Joy's spirits up.
I'm sure she would probably prefer to be with him, but we kept her company.
Yeah. I'll probably cry. Just being honest, I'll probably cry. I'll be really, like, happy. I'm, like, overwhelmed. Yeah.
First it was tears of him leaving, now tears of joy.
Yeah.
But 3 months is a long time. Joy seems worried Salim might be carrying some excess baggage.
I'm nervous at how he'll look. Like, he said he's been eating a lot, so I'm kind of nervous if he'll be like that, so... Holy crap. How are you?
Salim's flown in with his sister, but after the briefest of hugs, they're off again.
He forgot his phone somewhere, so he has to go get his bags and go get them.
Work here or
something? No, I study here.
Study here.
The tourist police office isn't the most romantic place for lovers to live.
He looks different a little. He's a little chubbier.
Yeah,
he's chubbier.
I'm sure he got some different variety of home-cooked meals.
Maybe before he had more muscle, now it's more just food.
As Salim goes in search of his phone, he knows the big reunion's in danger of falling flat.
Today's supposed to be a happy day for me, but this just ruined my mood. Should be with my girlfriend right now. But I'm here.
I thought we were just gonna, like, get him and go eat, probably, but, you know, it was different, so...
By the time Salim returns, without his phone, Joy and Jewel have to go to class. But they'll meet for dinner later. Salim can have the salad.
I'll see you again, maybe. I'll see you again.
Maybe?
Bye.
Sounds like Salim could be in danger of losing more than his phone. Over in baggage reclaim, it's been a special day for Tantida. She took time off her busy duties to do some light stalking.
Around belt 15. I met my favorite singer. I follow him. Hello?
I can't find you.
12. To the end. Hello, welcome back. I think he is nice. I just like him. Many photos with his fans.
Tantida's heartthrob is Warawake Dhanawong, one of Asia's biggest pop stars, and he's just made her day.
This morning is my best morning.
Only love can do that. And it comes in all shapes and sizes. When Ray was posted to Thailand for work, he couldn't be parted from his best friends, Brusky and Hui.
So I came from Atlanta, Georgia yesterday, about 24 hours ago. I'm staying over here for 1 year and couldn't live without my dogs over here with me.
Ray's a man who's devoted to his pets.
The airline I flew is fantastic for animal care. They fly better than I have economy class before, so they have plenty of toys in there, which they haven't chewed too much. This is the house I'm renting in Bangkok, and this is where the dogs will swim, play, and terrorize the yard.
Pets, just like humans, need the right paperwork, including a certificate of health and an import permit on arrival.
To get them into the country, you got to make sure they're healthy, a lot of veterinarian certifications in your home country, a lot of paperwork, a lot of payments.
Paperwork completed, there's one more hurdle to jump, a spot check from the airport's own veterinary service, to make sure Brusky and Hui are fit to enter Thailand. With the dogs up to Thai standards, it's time for Brusky and Hui to meet their chauffeur and get a warm welcome to Bangkok.
Hello, my friend.
You need to teach them Thai.
สวัสดีครับ. Say, สวัสดีครับ.
And like everyone after a long flight, you can't beat that first stretch of the legs. All four of them.
Ready to go see your sister?
Welcome to Bangkok, my friend!
They'll keep me a lot busier, but I should be able to settle down. It'll feel more like a home versus a place to live.
So Brusky and Hui head off to begin their adventure, and they're not the only ones on the verge of a life-changing experience.
This is it. This is the last couple of minutes, if you will, looking like this.
Justin's hoping his facelift will bring him more luck with the ladies.
Yes, like crunch. Time. Single serve time.
Oh, operating room says it all. I can just say that.
Yes.
He's come to Thailand to lose his laughter lines, and it's working already.
I'm a little afraid to look down to see what's plugging my arms and things, but yeah, and just the fact I'm in a different country actually too, you know, I'm far from home. It's definitely crossing my mind right now. I'm sure these people know what they're doing.
Like a master tailor, Dr. Titty wields his scalpel, redraping Justin's skin into a more youthful position.
He might have scarred because the surgery is surgery. He can't do much. It costs something. The item will be come out like this. Our job is to place the scar in a concealed area. Yes, it's finished. Now just cleansing and pressure dressing and everything is okay. I think it's really go very smooth. So he should be fine. I think he's very successful for this operation. Yeah.
Justin will have to wait a while before the bandages come off, and then he can enjoy Dr. Titty's handiwork. Back at Bangkok Airport, Valentine's Day is well and truly over. Travis is stuck in immigration, battling to keep his family together.
We were dreaming that we'd sort of like get through and go get a coffee and have a cigarette, get in a taxi.
Ex-soldier Travis and girlfriend Cheap have flown in to visit her parents before starting their new life together in Australia with daughter Rinrada. They were hoping for a smooth ride through, but they've been detained by Captain Bert.
Yeah, in this case, the woman and the man has a family and they want to go to Thailand, but the man has something that irregular in Thai last time that he came here. So he in the back lives here. So we try to figure it out.
I was deported from Thailand last year, about 4 months ago. I had an argument with the Australian embassy, and then the Australian Federal Police issued an arrest warrant in Thailand to bring me back to Australia. So now that's in my passport, so they're just pulling me aside, and I think they're just going to ask me what went on.
It might not be as easy as Travis thinks. The case will be handled by Bert's no-nonsense boss, Inspector Mwai.
สวัสดีค่ะ.
And she's not happy with his story. Because Travis is on the immigration watch list, Mwai must make a decision. Can he stay or should he go?
Because the blacklist name cannot enter to my country, so we have to make a decision to allow to my country or not later. Yes.
If Travis doesn't get in, he could end up in the immigration detention center, not the most romantic spot in the city.
Immigration detention center here in Bangkok. There's, you know, a few hundred people in a cell. People taking turns to stand up. People are crazy and dying in there, and also it's really bad.
The last time Travis was deported, he missed the precious 6 months of his daughter's life.
She's only one, so that's like almost half her life I've already missed already.
Inspector Mwai shows little sign of leniency.
The case of blacklist, I not think too much because it's no good guy, right? Sorry to say with him.
Jeep returns and it's bad news for Travis.
So they say I can't leave the airport, but I have to stay at the airport.
His family can stay, but he's not going to be allowed in.
Australian Federal Police breaking up families again. Fuckers. Sorry, fucker.
Travis is led away down to the basement, leaving Jeep and Rinrada to travel on alone.
So they've told my girlfriend and my daughter they have to leave. That's what I'm more worried about. Is Jeep, she's still gonna go north. We still gotta take her back to her parents. About 7 hours away up north. And then do it all by herself. It'll be harder. I've got to get a ticket out of the country, ASAP. I really don't know what's going on. I have to go back to Australia tonight. Apparently 12 o'clock, I've got a flight back.
Travis has a tough battle ahead if he's to persuade the authorities to allow him back in to see his family. Ever since his facelift surgery, Justin's been keeping a low profile while still taking in the sights.
Okay, let's go.
And today's the day the bandages finally come off.
Ooh. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh, I just cannot believe the difference. Oh, those stitches. I look like Frankenstein. Oh, the feeling in my stomach is just incredible. I have a jaw and neckline now I have now. My profile is so much better. And when I go to smile, those laugh lines no longer take over my face.
It'll take a while before the swelling subsides, but the facelift's already lifted Justin's spirits, and he's lost his heart to Thailand.
I love it. I understand why people come here now. People are very welcoming of tourists, very kind. It makes it hard to go home.
While Justin goes sightseeing, Pat and Ken are spending their final hours in Bangkok, looking back on their holiday.
It's upside down.
You said to me, you always do the other way around.
They squeezed in a few days on the island of Phuket, and Ken even had a go on the elephants.
It wasn't as scary as I thought it might be on the back of the elephant, was it?
No, it wasn't scary.
Because they let you climb on a high platform to get on it, because you always think maybe you'd have to climb onto it, but you just get onto it sort of straight across, don't you?
But it's been about spending quality time with their son Nathan and his new boyfriend Ark.
Having seen him in his environment, you feel he's in a good place. He's obviously feels settled where he is, and I think that is the word, isn't it?
Settled, really. And he seems to know where he's going to, so, and what he wants.
Yeah.
When Nathan first came out, it wasn't easy for his mum and dad.
Came as a bit of a shock to us, you know. He just said, I've got something to tell you, and he said, I'm gay. And the immediate thing is, poor old Nate, he must have gone through all sorts before he came to tell us, because we're Christians, you know, and you do get the stereotypical Christian view, the standard view, and Nathan telling us that made us stop and think a lot more about the subject.
Can you do it?
Yeah, it was interesting. He said he was glad of his upbringing, that it was quite a normal upbringing-ish, you know, that we did.
I was so surprised.
Yes, I was. Well, there's your compliment. You know, sometimes you think you bring your children up too strictly, or you make them go to church, which we did all go to church as a family. So to hear him turn around and say, I am quite glad I had that upbringing, that was quite nice to hear, actually. Probably worth coming to Bangkok to hear it.
As we arrive at the airport, Pat's not sure who will miss her more, son Nathan or her new best friend Ark.
Gave Ark a hug this morning and he was really sad, he filled up, so it was nice. Well, filled up, his eyes filled up. It was nice.
Who's relief? It's called relief.
No, yeah. It's not. He's going to miss me. He's going to miss me. If you're not going to miss me, Ark is going to miss me.
Well, they first met Ark, I was a bit worried, but then straight away they clicked and Mum finds him, I think. Which is always good.
And he's good looking.
And he's good looking.
Also heading home today is the new look Justin. Hoops come to see him off at the airport, though he'd much rather be staying here.
New stay in Bangkok, 2 weeks. How you feel?
Oh, like a new man. I feel refreshed.
Yeah.
Relaxed.
Yeah.
Re-energized.
Yeah.
Rejuvenated.
And it seems like his new look's working already, because Justin's found love and life is sweet.
when I came here, you told me, you said, you fall in love with my girl and everything.
And then true or not?
Yeah, well, maybe, yeah.
Oh, I don't need you to say me.
I thought you were joking.
I'm not joking.
I know. I didn't laugh at your joke, but now I think.
And now,
that's
now
true.
You say, oh, that what book say is not joke, it's true.
Yeah, well, she's a very nice girl.
I know. Let's see.
Not everyone finds love in Thailand. Not Travis, who's separated from his family.
They told to leave.
Not Hair Puppikoffer, on his way back to Switzerland after his ill-starred internet romance.
That's finished, lady.
But the only worry for Justin is how to get through passport control.
It's the first test of whether or not my new face matches my passport, so... And I'm sure Thai passport control will put it to the test, so...
Come on, mate, you've not changed that much.
Have a sip, John.
How's that thing?
Nathan saying a last goodbye to his mum and dad.
Yeah, a little bit emotional to see them go. But it's been nice, it's been a fun time, so I think they're happy to see me with a guy that I love. Yeah, they're just happy to see me happy.
So it's Saudi to the world's most loved up airport.
Happy with that.
And remember, always arrive early for your flight, take good care of your parents, and be careful when dating on the internet. Next time at Bangkok Airport, there's no way out.
I've lost my British passport. I'm stuck in Bangkok.
An ex-soldier stares defeat in the face.
I'm thinking about it. Things keep getting done in jail.
There's mayhem at the full moon party.
That was epic. 30,000 people raving on the beach.
And the tourist police help out another customer.
Hey, I'm gonna call you.
When we check in again at Bangkok Airport.
Tune into Radio 1 tomorrow morning as 50 Shades of Grey's Jamie Dornan joins Nick Grimshaw live for the Radio 1 breakfast show from 6:30. And Keep It 3 is coming up next. It's brand new Crims and it's the last in the series as Luke becomes the prison hero after Jason nominates him for a dangerous raid. Going out in style.